This is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba, and in this video I'm going to lead you through how compiling works with processing and explain the Java virtual machine. So we've talked already about programming languages and the fact that they're really designed for people. They use words that are human understandable. And you might think, wow, when I look at programming stuff, it doesn't look very understandable to me. But that might be just because you're a novice. And so they really are much better than what was available before, which was machine language, which is basically just binaries, zeros and ones. And that is not human readable at all. So we like to work in programming languages because they're human readable and they're a lot easier to work with, but the machines can't understand them. So we need this middle thing called the compiler, which takes our program that we've written in a programming language like processing and turns it into the ones and zeros of machine language that the computer can understand and use. So compilers are absolutely necessary. Everything has to be compiled. And so when you've bought software before and loaded it on your computer, it's already been compiled when you bought it. It's been packaged to be executable, to be able to run right away. All right, so there's a complication here, which is that different computers speak different languages, as in different machine languages. So there's always the rivalry between Windows and Macs, and you know, this is cute and funny, but actually it's more serious than that. They speak slightly different machine languages. And so the orders of the ones and zeros and things like that has to be different across different platforms. And it's not just Windows and Macs either. Think about your gaming consoles or all the different smartphones that are available. All of these have all different machine code language that they speak. There's also things like smart fridges now and other home appliances that run apps, and even cars have apps now. So all of these different platforms speak different languages. So this starts to get crazy, because if we write a program and it's human readable, then you'd think, well, wow, now we have to compile it for all of these different platforms. And these are just three of the many platforms. So we need all these different compilers that will compile this program into something that each of these platforms can actually understand and use. Whew, that doesn't seem very scalable. That's problematic. And what happens if we introduce a new platform and it has a different language? Well, then the problem is that we'd have to create a compiler, and every program that exists would have to be run through that new compiler. And that would be problematic. That's not going to be very easy to do, and it would prevent innovation. It would prevent us from developing new platforms. So there must be a solution, right? Indeed, there is. The solution is a virtual machine. So the idea is we have programming code, and then we're going to send it through a virtual machine compiler to get this virtual machine language. What is it? It's sort of this kind of machine language, but it's something that then can run on different platforms, because what will happen now is every platform will have a virtual machine on it. So the Windows PC has a virtual machine program platform. So does the Mac, so do the gaming systems, etc. So we compile once to this virtual machine language and then send it off to all these different platforms. And so this is how Java works, okay? So when a new platform is introduced, we create a Java virtual machine for that platform. We put it on that platform. So here's the Nintendo Wii. We put the Java virtual machine on there. And then any existing Java programs, because they've been compiled to the virtual machine, can just load on here and run. Okay, so we don't need to recompile them. So this is really great, right? So you may be wondering, okay, that's Java, but what about processing? So in our class, we're going to be using processing. That's our human readable code. The processing compiler is actually going to create Java code, which is also human readable. And then that's going to be sent to the virtual machine compiler, and that will then be able to run on various platforms. So here's just some little bit more detail on this. The files that you get. So when we are programming and processing, we have a PDE file, and that goes through the Java compiler, and we end up with something called Java bytecode. That's the virtual machine language, and that is stored in a .class file. So you can't look at a class file. It's not human readable. It looks like a bunch of gobbledygook because it's run by the virtual machine. And then on whatever platform you're on, there's a Java virtual machine. So Windows has this, Mac has this, different phones have this, all sorts of platforms have a Java virtual machine, which enables these class files to actually be run on that platform. All right, so that's all you really need to know. And there's a lot of detail there. It's not necessary for you to memorize all that detail, but you have to understand the idea of what compiling is, the idea that it's taking human readable programming language and turning it into something that is machine readable. And you want to understand that Java uses this virtual machine mechanism so that there's a Java virtual machine that can be built and sit on any platform so that Java programs can run on them. All right, that's all for now.